predicate of the other. So Senate Majority Leader McConnell says, obviously, he's not going to bring the Senate back. So this isn't going to happen until Joe Biden is president. I'm sorry. Some legal experts, though, say that that ends the whole thing, that you cannot hold a trial once the person you are removing from office is no longer in office. You've just written an op-ed in The Washington Post about this, and you say President Trump can be tried and convicted after leaving office. Why? Explain.
Well, basically, the Constitution's text makes it clear that as long as you are an officer when you commit an impeachable offense, the ability to convict you and prevent you from repeating your dangerous activities doesn't cease. If it were written otherwise, it would be crazy. Then William Belknap, who was Secretary of War in 1876, thought he could game the system by resigning his office minutes before the impeachment was returned. But then the Senate, by a vote of 37-29, held, understandably, you can't get away with it that way. It's not like when someone says you're fired, you say, so you can't fire me, I've already resigned.
Right.
The fact is that the Constitution was designed so that the most dangerous characters couldn't escape the important remedy of being taken out of public office in the future simply by resigning. That won't work. And although there are some scholars I really admire, in particular, Judge Michael Luttig, who doesn't agree with me but says he thinks I've got a powerful argument, I think the case is pretty clear. And there's a lot of argument, both historical and textual, for the view that I have about this.
All right. So-